Hello everyone, I'm really excited about this week's video. It's affordable vegan makeup and everything that I've curated for this look is under £20, and that wasn't easy because a lot of the natural, organic, vegan, cruelty-free brands tend to be quite toppy, over £20. Anyway, I've got quite an abundance of makeup now, and if you want me to do more of these, I definitely can, but this is my first look and I hope you enjoy it. The first product I'm going in with for my SPF is by The Body Shop. Now, I have a friend, Zoe, who basically runs my channel. She does all the really organised aspects of it because I'm the opposite, disorganised. And she introduced me to this product. Have you tried it? It's really lovely. It's really fresh. I looked into it. I bought it. And if you love the zesty smell of oranges, then you will love this product. You know, makeup and skincare is definitely an enjoyable process if you get the right product. Something that smells as fresh as this is definitely enjoyable and it gives you great protection. Possibly not for oily skin. It's really, really hydrating. That would be the one thing I would say about it, but I've loved it and it's a really great base for makeup. So that's where we're starting. Next, I'm gonna use Balance Me. Now, this is a really lovely hyaluronic primer and you know I love hyaluronic. It's run by two ladies, it's a British company, and it just comes out like so. And I'm going to place it just on those drier areas. Now, for those of you who use hyaluronic, you'll know it's kind of one of those products that's a bit like, meh. You put it on your face and you kind of go, okay, well, let's hope that works. It doesn't have that sort of satisfying effect that a moisturiser would have, so that instantaneous effect. It kind of happens sort of throughout the day. You realise that your skin doesn't dry out. So that's where I tend to get dry. So I'm just using that primer along here so that my skin has got that lovely tacky feeling ready for makeup. So the base that I found the best, and it's a medium coverage, is again from The Body Shop, and it's called Fresh Nude Foundation. Now, I am actually in between the shades, which is slightly annoying. So I've got 050 and 030. I don't mind mixing it together, but you know, maybe for a consumer, you don't want to have two foundations, but you know, my loyal subscribers know how much I love two foundations. So I am going to mix these together because I'm still quite yellow on my neck, and the 050 is just a little bit more golden. So I'm just going to place this on my hand and you can see the colour difference there. Very sunny day here in London. I'm going to use a Real Techniques brush. They are synthetic, so therefore they have not come into any contact with any animals whatsoever. And I'm going to use 050 just around the perimeter of my face because you know I like to lighten my face. So I'm just mixing them sort of like this, very haphazardly on my face to make sure that I get that right colour. And this particular brush, if it has a name, contour brush. I'm not using it for a contour at all. I'm using it to apply my base, but it's soft and fluffy, so it gives me a lovely soft application of makeup, nothing too much. I don't want to drench my skin because I'm moving into a more medium coverage because of the type of year, whereas my sort of sheer soft hydrating foundations, the Trini and the Charlotte Tilbury Unisex Glow, I need a little bit more now. But I don't want to kind of go in with a full-on full coverage, so I'm just blending these two colours together. Lovely. It feels really hydrating. It gives great coverage. Be careful not to put too much around my fine lines in my mouth because it builds up. Lovely. Couldn't be easier. Now, e.l.f. has amazing brand. Eyes, lips, face, abbreviated. I actually didn't know that. Straight over my head. Probably hasn't gone straight over yours, but it's only a few years ago I realised what that actually stood for. It's a brilliant brand and it is entirely vegan, so that makes it simple. I'm going to go in with the Flawless Concealer under my eyes and the Camo Concealer, 16 hours around my chin and around my nose. These are ace, cheap as chips. Does this remind you of something? Mm-hmm. Reminds me very much of that Tarte Shape Tape Concealer. So that's where I have my redness there. I'm going to pat that in there and maybe just use my fingers. Now I'll do a little bit more, I think, just around my nose because they're the areas that I tend to be really red, and I'm going to use my finger around my nose, not a brush, because I really need to wedge it in because it really annoys me. I used to swim a lot when I was younger. I just think I've broken so many veins. but I just have a constant redness there, which is, we know, not that much of a deal, but you know, it's one of those things. You can see how well that blends in. It's such a good concealer for the price. It's brilliant, and there's so many shades as well. Lovely. This would be much too heavy under my eyes. It would make my eyes crinkly. It would sort of pucker my eyes because my eyes are 46 years old. So let's do a little bit of the Flawless Concealer and just in that dark area, just in that area where I need coverage. And then I'm going to blend it through. Push the product in. Honestly, you cannot go wrong. It's such a brilliant find. I love, love these concealers. Push that in, and again, it's just slightly lighter. The shades that I'm using in both is light beige. And there we are. I'm going to see whether I need any powder. I want to see how that base works. I haven't been using any powder with it as I've been testing it. Oh, do you know what? I can see a little bit of my pigmentation coming through here and here after the summer. Even though I'm a factor 50 girl, every day, and I do love being in the sun. I need the sun, like a flower. So, you know, if it brings out a little bit of pigmentation, so be it. I'll just have to blend that very slightly like that, just to give me a better finish. I think if you're gonna go for that medium coverage, you kind of have got to go for it. You can go for that sort of like soft, natural finish, or you go for something that's really perfected. I'm really happy with that. My ears are a bit red. Nice. Okay, so next I'm going to talk about highlighters. Now, this was quite tricky in this market because they were either quite sparkly or they just faded really quickly. And in fact, some of the Kiko ones were like that. I put them on my hand and I thought, oh, that feels nice. And then they just faded, like there was nothing, there was no difference between each of my hands. This is liquid chrome and the shade is Beam Me Up. It is a punchy highlighter, let me warn you, and it might not be your cup of tea, but it is the highlighter that gave the most gleam. And if you use it sparingly or mix it with your moisturiser, you're just going to get that lovely glowy feel. And the older we get, the kind of more grey and sort of dark we feel. So if you are one of those people who has dry skin like me, you might like it. This was my best one that I found. Now, the applicator is pretty shocking, and the formula is too thick for the applicator, but we can get our heads around that because, you know, we haven't spent a lot of money on it and we only need a little bit. So putting the applicator just doesn't need to be a dropper really, it just needs to be a little spatula, but that doesn't matter because it's still going to do the job. Now I'm going to put it on with my finger so that you can see what a lovely kick of light it does. Now, because I work in daylight and looking towards my driveway outside, I don't overlight my videos because I like them to be as natural as possible. You'll see a nice soft gleam. It won't be too much, but it's definitely enough. And I just put that under my brow and just softly blend that into my base. And I obviously haven't put any powder on, so it just blends well. You would only powder, obviously, after you'd put your liquid highlighter and blush on. But I really like that. So it's punchy, not particularly great packaging, but the effect is brilliant. So I think if you're on a budget, then that's definitely one to buy, and that's by Barry M. My next great find was these little blushes from Makeup Academy. I think they were £2.25. And the great thing about one of the chemists that I go to, which is equivalent to the American drugstore, obviously, is that they had all the different sections of makeup in each of the ranges had a little green leaf on, meaning they were vegan. That's really helpful because actually it's really not very clear. So I'm going to use this, just very much like the Glossier ones actually, in a very similar colour. You know I love these kind of like soft caramel colours. And with the makeup that I'm going to do, this works really well. Again, I'm just going to place with my finger because originally when I tried this, I thought, oh, I bet it fades. It doesn't. It's cooling on application. And it's a really lovely sort of trans-seasonal tan. Now, don't worry, I'm not going all camouflage on you. I'm just showing you how to put it a little bit around your hairline, either side. Go in with your same brush that you used to blend in your highlight and the foundation and just delicately mix it in because there's a little bit of foundation and highlighter there. It just migrates all the colours together, making everything sort of seamlessly. And I think that's really pretty. And when it dries, you can then use a powder blush over the top, which I might do in a minute. We'll see how that goes. But you just need to make sure that it's dry. But I think it's really soft and delicate. Great little packaging. They've got lots of different colours, so I'll do more, like I said, if you like. But that's a really great product, again, for the price. Right, so I'm going to do my brows next, and I'm using a brow pencil from Delilah. This is a beautiful brand. I love their lipsticks and their blushes, and they've got great eyeliners too. But because we're under £20, I was limited to what I could use. So let's brush through the brows, lift them up, and I really need to build my tail up. So I'll start from the bottom. It's really minute. Now the colour that I've chosen is ash, because it's slightly cooler in colour, because my brows can sometimes pick up a lot of red, and it just looks a little bit more natural if it's that cooler colour. I just need to extend my tail out that far and just bring this underneath. Okay, so just going on to the next one, same vibe, extending the tail very slightly out, filling in this patchy bit there and just extending the brow towards my nose just to kind of open out my eyes a little bit more. Lovely, great colour. It's lovely. I mean, it does take a little bit of time to get my brows on, but then when I've got them on, I feel much more put together. Just make sure that's sort of soft and not too hard in the centre there, so it doesn't detract from your eyes. Now this is a lovely brand, Lavera. Again, totally natural, and it's a mineral eyeshadow. Now this colour I absolutely love. It's called Shiny Taupe, so it's kind of one of those soft neutrals. I'm going to apply it with a Real Techniques base shadow brush. Really lovely, and I'm going to use it just across my lid. Again, it's a lovely kind of cool taupey colour with a little bit of sheen, not too much. I'm just going to blend that into my lid. Incidentally, my nail varnish is again Barry M. And Barry M's got some really great nail polish colours actually. I mean, there might be more brands that are vegan or have vegan products in them, but they're just not advertising them. And I'm sure if they did that and they really informed people that, you know, what wasn't vegan and what was vegan, that they'd probably sell more products. Because even for me, you know, you'd assume that I was sort of in the know. It was actually, I had to really sort of sit down and focus to be absolutely sure that I hadn't made a mistake and that every product is that. So obviously it's very different to being cruelty-free. Vegan makeup is all about products that have had no contact or use of any animal byproducts. You'd usually find sort of the ingredients you need to look out for would be carmine, which is a deep red, so that's obviously found in lipsticks, cream blushes, lanolin, keratin, collagen, beeswax. There's quite a list of products that you need to be aware of, but if that's your thing, I'm sure you are aware of it. I'm going to use a little bit of eyeliner. I love how soft this is. It's right up my street and I like the coolness of it. I'm going to use a Bare Minerals really fine liner. Now this colour is called Sharp Charcoal. Because this is soft, this look, I don't want it to be too soft against my top, so I'm going to do a little bit of tight lining and I'm going to really wedge this in between my lashes, really working it in. So it does feel a bit scratchy. That's not the product, that's the pressure that I'm putting on. I'm being quite heavy-handed with it just to really press the pigment in and extend it out as far as I can before my lid drops down. I need to make sure that I'm defying gravity at all times. So that's nice, that's going to give me a little bit of bulk, and because it's charcoal, it's nice and soft, it's not as heavy as a black. Oh, someone going over my speed bumps outside the house. So yeah, Bare Minerals, another lovely brand, so many lovely brands, but like I said, I just wanted to kind of condense everything so that it was easy for you to sort of navigate a vegan look if you wanted. Just there, because when you look at someone, you just have that air of your eye defined. It just gives you a sharper finish. And I have to pull my lid, because look, you can see now, that's it. Those little gaps are now filled in, and that just gives you a much tighter, more intense look to your eye. Right, so for mascara, I went to Superdrug, and I've got B. And this, again, is a really lovely all-vegan brand, and a very, very, very good price. And it's got the wand, the kind of wand that I like, nice and skinny, because I like to get it to the root. And then the other side is like a softer bristle brush, which kind of gives you a more feathery finish. So I'm going to go in with a tight one first, but I just think for the price, this is a really, really great mascara. Look, straight in. This literally gets placed straight into my lash. I'm not really so worried about the tips, because I'm going to use the fluffy one to sort of feather them out so that they don't end up looking too cloggy. This is more for sort of depositing mascara heavily at the roots, so we get that nice graduation of product. I do love a double-ended product. Space saving, usually value for money. And it's nice to have two different brushes because they do different things. Got a little bit under my eye there. Right, very nice. Fluffy end, quickly before it dries, obviously. And the key is always to push up the tips of your lashes as much as you can so that you see them. If you have short lashes, just honestly, if you have short lashes, use a waterproof mascara. Not sure if I've shared that tip with you before, I must have done. Waterproof mascara is great at pushing straight. See, look, you see, the moment I use a fluffy brush, I then get, here we are, there's a cotton bud. Sorry about that. The moment I start using a big brush, it just goes everywhere. So there we go. Now I've just held the mascara wand. So I'm just giving you this real fake world that everything's calm and organised. It really isn't. Okay, back to it. And oh, look, mascara works really well just before it sets. If you've got time just to kind of maybe do your lips or cheeks and then come back to your lashes, just as the mascara dries, it tends to give you more lift. So, yeah, so going back to my tip, if you've got very short, straight lashes, waterproof mascara is great for lifting them. I can show you on a film if you would like. I need to write down all these films. There's just so much to talk about, girls, isn't there? So much to talk about. And guys, I know I've got a few guy fans as well. Great. So I'm happy with that so far. Lips. Actually, you know what? I might put a bit more blush on. I love this e.l.f. blush. I thought this worked quite well with my top, and you know how much I love a really cool bright pink, but I just thought this is a little bit more seasonal. But I'm going to do my lip first and then I'll come back, because I don't want it to be too much. I kind of quite like that sort of creamy-ish complexion, because it doesn't look too dolly or dumb. Right, I love this colour. It's a liquid lipstick called Bow from Delilah. It's a really beautiful liquid lipstick, and I keep telling you, honestly, if you get the right ones, Bobbi Brown do really lovely ones, this Delilah is a lovely one. It's a great way to shape your lips if you don't like lip liner. So I need to just build up my top lip line, because it is slightly feathery. And I'm always paranoid that colour is going to move. This has seen me through even an event where I was talking out. And once I get going, it's hard to stop me. Super soft, very light, and it doesn't pucker. It doesn't pucker my lips. It's a lovely seasonal rosy berry, isn't it? Funny, isn't it, how emotive we've become about shades. I've been obsessed with, like, you know, coral, oranges, tangerines, and now just sort of instinctively You change, don't you? Your eye changes and... So you can see how that really sits quite nicely on my lips. I don't have perfect dreamy lips. I'd love to have massive lips. I've got lip envy actually when I look at people. I think, oh, if I could just have those lips, everything would be all right. No, that's totally ridiculous. I'm going to adjust this makeup slightly, and I'm going to go back with the thin mascara because I'm feeling a bit bare on my eyes. I'm going to use mascara just on my lower lashes, just to make it a little bit stronger. I look a bit bare. I think because I'm wearing a patterned top as well, it sort of look a bit plain. So just pull my lower lashes down. And it was really long wearing, this mascara as well. I thought it would be crumbly and not last very long, but it has ticked all the boxes. Right, and that's allowed that lip to dry. So another great brush. This is a concealer brush again from B, but it's a perfect size. Most of my clients, when I apply colour to their cheek, I use a small brush like this. And again, it's synthetic. It's just a really great brush. So here we are, just gonna tap a little bit off my hand. And because I want lift, I don't want like rosy glow cheeks. I just want a little bit of lift. And because the liquid blush has dried, this sits beautifully on there. Whereas if it was very creamy, I couldn't place the powder on top because it would go into, it would start smudging and lifting off the makeup. Just to make sure that I don't look like an 80s queen, I'm just going to soften that in circular motions just to blend it in. It's just all about that soft finish, isn't it? And as well with the highlighter, it also dries. It's not sort of a greasy, oily finish on your skin. I think that's just a little bit more, it ties everything in together. One more thing. This is Bare Minerals and it's their new Gen Nude lipstick. This is Can't Even. Now, I do like this look, and if I was presenting or working, I might wear it, the liquid lipstick by itself. But I do tend to like to have hydration on it, so I would normally wear like just a little bit of a hydrating lipstick over the top or something like this. Now this is a gloss, but it's just a really modern contemporary gloss, meaning it's not sticky, it doesn't go everywhere, it's just really comfortable to wear. But I just love how the liquid lipsticks make my lips look. They just look fuller and better. I'm just going to place that in the center there and not too close to my lip line or my fake lip line. Squidge it all in and just blend it slightly. Literally got mascara on my fingernail. Yeah. Lovely. Yep, I think all that works quite nicely together. What do you think? A very pretty seasonal vegan makeup. I hope you liked it. If you'd like more, very happy to do more. And yeah, please write me a comment because I love to read them when I can. Sometimes I'm like straight away and sometimes I don't respond for a couple of days, but I do appreciate every single one. Bye for now, everyone.